Hello and welcome to part 14 of the build series for the Rifield models StuG 4. So last episode we basically finished putting the top of the hull on the model, and this one was just for dry fitted for showing what it looks like, but we take that one off for now. This roof is also dry fitted just for show, so we take that off like so, and then we are ready to get started with today's adventures, which will be trying to assemble a few things for painting. So we have this back wall where we can attach these two hooks. We can build the towing wires, and we can prepare them for painting. So I have already drilled out these holes, and now we just need to glue these hooks in. Before we get too far into the video, I'd like to thank all of my subscribers, current and new ones. It's very appreciated, the support that you give me for this adventure. And as you see, this one is nearing its completion, and the next build will be the new Rifield model King Tiger. I don't know exactly when that will start, but I guess we have a good couple of weeks left of this one before we can start with the King Tiger. So that's the two hooks attached. Then we have the string for the towing line, the towing wires. So we try to stretch this out to get it the even length, and then we simply cut it off here. Then we take the loops for the wires. We get some glue in there. And then it's time to see whether or not we can successfully get this rope or this piece of string into the tiny hole. This may be something that I do off cam because I'm doubting it will be as easy as it seems. Yeah. This will be a side project for the next episode. I don't want to bore you trying to fix this. So instead we move on to A14, where we need to attach this tiny piece. So, and the shovel here I will have to paint separately before I glue it to that piece. So we go to the next step, and again this all needs to be painted before I attach them to the model. So we go on to the cooling. And we see if we can get this all assembled. So that one will go in here. And I noticed I need to do some cleaning here. And then this one goes in here. Right here. we glue them from the back to make sure they stay seated as they are. And then we need the two side pieces. That's that one, and then we have this drive shaft. We need the long one, and this one with only one hole. And then this one needs to go like so. Then we have this one. And we have the short stubby one. Just to make sure they fit correctly, we put this one there. Oops. Would be nice if they stayed in place. And since these two are in different colors, I don't want to glue these two together. There we go, we leave it like that while the glue goes off. Next we have the doors for the rear hatch. And again, this needs to be painted, and I'm also intending on leaving the doors open, so I will not be gluing them to the hatch later on. Just need the handle for. That's that door done for now. Then we have this one. So I have this door that goes here. There we go, that's that one. So next up is the small box that contains the spare road wheels. And that's these pieces. There is also this piece of photo etch, but I'm hesitant to add that now, because if I add this on, then I don't think I can get the wheels out. So we'll see. We will start with these pieces and see if we can get it to hold together. place to go in between. That will hold the extra road wheels. Like so. But it needs to be painted first, so we'll just leave that to dry. Put the road wheels in the spares box for now. Then the next step is building the other side here, A17. And again, this piece I need to paint separately, so I'll just add the small piece here at the end for now. And finally, for this part of episode 14, we will have a look at the gun barrel and the muzzle brake. Start with this piece. I think we will start with the muzzle brake to the barrel. See if we can get first thing is, I don't know which way this one goes. It looks like it's going on this way. And then this all goes onto here. And that's the gun barrel done. With the muzzle brake on. So, next we're looking at assembling a few pieces to the body of the tank. But I think I will call it here, and I will attach these loops to the towing wires. I will get this painted up and I will get back to you once we start putting all of this together. So bye for now. It won't be more than a few seconds for you, but it might be a bit longer for me. Okay, let's continue. If you look at the instructions here, it says to cut these wires, or the string, to 150 millimeters length. And if you do that, you run into a slight issue. If you add this wire, like it says in the instruction, you go across here, back over. As you can see, this string is way too long. And if you measure from here to here, you will see it's actually 5, 10, 15, 17 centimeters, or 170 mil long. So what you need to do is to cut the string at about 130 mil. So you get roughly 150 mils between the two loops. That way you won't have too much string in between, because if you look here, it's about 35 millimeters from here to here, and 35 times 2, that's 140 millimeters. So basically the string, the entire wire should not be much longer than this once it's stretched out. So what I will have to do now is to cut the string off and then re-glue this loop to make sure that it's the correct length. And with this I will conclude this episode. I'll hope you have a good week and happy modeling, and I see you back in the next one. Bye bye.